I abans de marxar, els deixem una petita joia històrica d'aquelles que es poden trobar per internet, ja que acabem de parlar de les decisions de caràcter gairebé històric que haurà de prendre el nou govern espanyol i també molts altres governs d'àmbit europeu o mundial. Vegem com es van explicar algunes decisions que encara avui estan marcant la nostra economia. Per exemple, el 15 d'agost del 1971, el president Richard Nixon va haver d'anunciar que per primer cop des del final de la guerra els Estats Units es desdeien del seu compromís amb tot el món i decidien devaluar el dòlar. En concret, es decidia desvincular-se del patró or i de tot el que significava, des del 1944, el sistema de Bretton Woods. Així ho va justificar Richard Nixon.
In the past 7 years, there's been an average of one international monetary crisis every year. Now, who gains from these crises? Not the working man, not the investor, not the real producers of wealth. The gainers are the international money speculators. Because they thrive on crises, they help to create them. In recent weeks, the speculators have been waging an all-out war on the American dollar. The strength of a nation's currency is based on the strength of that nation's economy. And the American economy is by far the strongest in the world. Accordingly, I have directed the Secretary of the Treasury to take the action necessary to defend the dollar against the speculators. I have directed Secretary Connally to suspend temporarily the convertibility of the dollar into gold or other reserve assets, except in amounts and conditions determined to be in the interest of monetary stability.